Hello everyone. Today I wanted to do a video because it's that time of year. I wanted to talk about New Year's goals. I'm preparing mine right now, so I thought it would be a good time to talk about them. And yes, you heard correctly. I didn't say New Year's resolutions, I said New Year's goals, and that's on purpose. And so yeah, let me get into that. Why don't I have New Year's resolutions? I used to set up these New Year's resolutions and now I don't. I always set up New Year's goals. And there's a big, very significant difference between the two, at least to me. New Year's resolutions, you've heard them all before. They'll usually be something like, I want to quit smoking. I want to go to the gym every day. I want to go on a diet, not eat meat anymore, do this, do that, whatever it might be. You have all these New Year's resolutions that everyone comes up with. And maybe you decide, I'm going to quit smoking. And then you don't smoke, except one day you go out with your friends and you're drinking and then you do smoke. And then maybe a week or two later, you get very stressed out about something. You're like, I need a cigarette. And so you do have a cigarette. And then by February, mid-February, something along those lines, you're pretty much smoking again. Same with the gym. You decide, I'm gonna go to the gym 3 times a week. And so that first week, you go 3 times a week. The second week, you do as well. But then later, you're really busy with work, so you can't do it. You're like, okay, it's Wednesday, I won't go today. I'll just go tomorrow on Thursday. You go on Thursday, but then that's it. So you went twice that week. And then later, something else happens, or you're hungover, this, that, and the other. And then by mid-February, once again, you're not going 3 times a week. And that's the problem with resolutions. As soon as you fall off the wagon, as soon as you drop the ball, then all of a sudden, that's it. No more New Year's resolution. And the reason I like New Year's goals is that you have a goal to shoot for, which doesn't mean that every single day you need to do that and otherwise that's it for the year. But it means that you can still shoot for your goal. And if you get a bit further behind or if you don't do something today, that's okay. Because tomorrow you can work twice as hard and still try to achieve that goal. And so, for example, let's say you're a freelancer and you're starting out and you're saying, okay, then by the end of this year, I want to be earning, I don't know, $2,000 or $3,000 a month from freelance translation. That's my goal. So you get starting. You start work now and you start creating your profile and online presence, trying to find clients, trying to pitch new clients here, there, and try to get as many as you can and try to make them recurring clients, et cetera, et cetera. And try to see how you can achieve your goal. Now, if you have one day where you're too busy to do something or too hungover or whatever it might be, that's fine. You just go back into it with double the energy the next day. And to me, this has always worked a lot better than New Year's resolutions. This idea of goals. And in fact, later what I'll do is I don't have only these goals for the whole year, but I will divide them up. And so I'll have 100-day goals, 200-day goals. And these are certain goals that I want to get done within the first 100 days. And I recommend this just because if you set a goal for the end of the year and then you forget about that goal because suddenly you get distracted, suddenly you get sidetracked, suddenly you have to work on this, that, and the other, and then December rolls around and you're like, oh wait, I had that goal there and completely forgot about it. It's a bit too late at that point. But if you give yourself intermediary goals, like every 100 days, then it helps to keep you on track. In fact, I have these 100-day goals, but then I divide it even further. And I'll have monthly and weekly goals. I try to divide it up as much as possible. For example, let's say you want to be earning $3,000 a month by the time December rolls around, right? This doesn't mean you're earning $3,000 every month, but it means that by December, you'll be earning $3,000 a month. That's the goal. So how do you divide it up? Let's say by the first 100 days, you want to be earning $1,000 a month. How do you go about that? It won't be easy. The first thing to do would be to, well, actually, I have some very good advice there because there's this course that I know online, link in the description below with a discount, where it teaches you step by step how to become a freelance translator. And so you can decide to do what's there and you can decide, okay, I'm going to follow this course and say by the first week, I'm going to have an online profile. By the second week, I'm going to be sending out, I don't know, one or two applications a day. And by the third week, I'm going to be sending 3 applications a day plus one cold email to a cold company somewhere there. By the fourth week, I'm going to be sending 5 applications a day, you know, something like that. And you come up with a plan so that you can be earning X amount by the first 100 days. And if you want, divide it up even more. By the first month, you'll have 1 client or 2 clients or something along those lines. And then it's a more manageable timeline that hopefully can then bring you to your goal. So I tend to do this. I tend to do this with business stuff. So if you're becoming a freelance translator, then that's your business stuff. I try to do it with health as well. And I try to see what, once again, not a resolution, I'm gonna go to the gym 3 times a week, but what's my goal? What do I want to have achieved by the end of the year? What do I want to weigh? Do I wanna have a 6-pack? Do I wanna run a 10K? Do I want to do whatever it might be? And again, if you decide I'm gonna run a 10K by the end of the year, then what's my 100-day goal? Maybe a 3K. And the best way to do this is to find a 3K in your neighborhood, in your town, in your city, and sign up for it right now. Say, okay, I'm committed to this 3K. So now I need to figure out, how do I do that? Well, 3K, how long does it take me to run a 3K? I don't know, 20 minutes, half an hour, let's say. Okay, let's see how long I can run now. And you start running, you're like, I can do 10 minutes before I take a break. Okay, so I know that I have 10 minutes now. Within 100 days, I need to be able to run 30 minutes so I can run my 3K. And so let's get into training and figure that part out. So all of these become a lot more manageable when you set a goal and then you divide it up. And this is just what's always been working for me. I try to do something for, once again, for business, something for health. I try to do something for edification. And this means education, like learning a new language or getting a certification or something along those lines. And I try to do something along the lines of fun and entertainment as well, because why not? But you can divide it up however you like. What I find is that if you create this goal and then you divide it up however you see fit, I do 100-day goals, 200-day goals, but then I divide it up even further just so I can achieve that 100-day goal. So the division by month is just for that 100-day goal. And then I reevaluate and see where I am so I can keep going on from there. And another thing that I try to do is keep myself accountable. I will tell other people about it. So I will tell my friends about it, I'll tell my family, and that way it kind of keeps me on track, because I know other people know what my goals are, and so they might be asking, so how are you going with that goal? Are you earning enough money? Do you have that 6-pack yet? Can you run a 10K? How's your race gonna be? Etc., etc. So see what you can do, see if you can do something along these lines. So see what you can do and see if you can do something similar along those lines, and if it helps you with this new year in 2018. And my plan is to do exactly this. I'm creating mine now, and I'm hoping that I can share it with you guys. And that way you guys can hold me accountable for my goals in the coming year. So anyway, let me know if you have what your goals might be for this coming year, because it'll help you as well. If you can write it down in the comments below, and let me know if you've come up with any already, or if you're working on some, or something that you would like to have accomplished. Think about it to yourself. What would make 2018 a great year? What will I have accomplished by the end of 2018 that'll make it a good year, a great year that I'll be happy with? And try to work toward that goal. Once again, if you found this video useful, if you like it, please don't forget to click thumbs up, because that's the best way that I can tell which videos work and which don't. And don't forget to subscribe if you want more videos for freelancing, for being an entrepreneur, for working online, for working for yourself, and obviously for being a freelance translator. And otherwise, I'll see you on the next video. Thanks. Bye. Sabedum.